And tonight, 13 Action News goes one-on-one with Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden. He had a very busy day here in the Valley, rallying supporters at two separate events.
And anchor Ross DiMatteo right now is live. And Ross, you talked to Biden and also a senior Trump advisor and found two very different views for guiding Las Vegas out of this pandemic.
Yeah, kind of as you would expect, Todd and Tricia. Well, campaign events these days are looking really different. Take Joe Biden's event here today, for example. All of his supporters were told to stay inside of their cars, wear their masks, and then they would push on the horn there and beep every time they liked a point that the former vice president would make. Really was quite a sight. But regardless of how you split it, when you get these two sides talking, it quickly turns into a slugfest.
And all the people who chose and parents chose to come to the United States are the reason why we are the nation we are. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
That is the sound of support for Joe Biden, who's feeling the love from Las Vegas Democrats, even from the safety and comfort of their cars.
I laid out a plan dealing with COVID all the way back in March.
But before Biden rallied his supporters outside of Southeast Career Technical Academy, he talked one-on-one with us about his plan to help the hospitality industry in cities like Las Vegas.
We're gonna be able to provide for extended unemployment insurance, provide for the kind of PPE that is needed for businesses and schools to open, sanitation, making sure we have ventilation in schools, all the things that could be done that could ease the burden on people right now. Nobody's going to come back out in terms of their being confident that they can stay at a place that's healthy and secure until we deal with COVID. And he's not doing either one of those things.
President Trump's assistant, Peter Navarro, pushing back on those claims, arguing Biden will shut the country down again if he wins.
President Trump's the open the economy president. Joe Biden would be the lockdown president. And that's a really, really big threat. If you look at Biden's history on this, when President Trump announced the travel ban on China on January 31st, Joe Biden called him a xenophobe, criticized that move, later had to apologize because what President Trump did with that is save hundreds of thousands, perhaps a million American lives with that.
Biden telling us he's done with all the division and that he is the man to bring the country closer together.
I'm confident that we can, in fact, bring things back together. You know, I've been told that, well, yeah, Joe, you used to always be able to do that. That was your reputation, cooperating Republicans. Things have changed. They haven't changed. They haven't changed. What's changed is the decision to change it. Politics has become so petty and so dirty. And what's happened is the president is so vindictive, Republicans who know better are afraid to cross him because he goes after them. With him gone, things will change.
Navarro says the difference between the candidates is clear. And if you want the pre-pandemic economy back, President Trump is your guy.
Nevadans can choose between Joe Biden's lockdown, Donald Trump's vibrant economy, Joe Biden's high tax regime, Donald Trump's tax cuts. And China is a big, big issue as well for all Americans. And if they keep taking our jobs, there's not going to be anybody be able to visit Las Vegas on vacation. They won't have any money.
And we only had the chance to ask Joe Biden three questions. You heard the answer to two of them there. The third one, we asked him repeatedly if he plans to pack the Supreme Court with extra justices. That is something a question he's avoided answering multiple times over the past few weeks. And I know it's a question that many of you viewers want to know before you cast your votes. We pressed him for an answer, and you will hear what he had to say coming up tonight after the game. Reporting live, Ross DiMatteo, 13 Action News.